Question number 11. If the sum of the first n terms of an AP is 4n minus n square, what is the first term? That is S1. What is the sum of first two terms? What is the second term? Similarly, find third term, comma the 10th term, and the nth terms, and the nth terms. Okay. So before solving this, I want to tell you something. What is sum of two terms? What is sum of two terms? Not using formula. Not using formula. A, A2, A3 you are having, no? In AP you will be having A, A2, A3, A4. Very good. Dash, dash, dash. So what is the sum of first two terms? It is nothing but A plus A2. Sum of three terms. Is A plus A2 plus A3. Or you can write it as S2 plus A3, or you can write it as S2 plus A3, because A plus A2 means what? Sum of first two terms. Sum of first two terms means what? S2. So S2 plus A3 you can also write. Sum of first one term is what? Sum of first one term is what? S1. Who will tell? You see here, sum of first two terms is A plus A2. Sum of first term means you have to take only A. You have to take only A. There is no other term added to it. So S1 is A. S1 is A. So sum of first term will always give us value of A. So this is very, very important fact that you must know. Sum of first term means it is always A. Solution given Sn equal to 4n minus n square. Sum of n terms formula they have given us for certain A and certain D value. What you have to calculate? You have to calculate the first term. See there what they are asking. A1 is equal to what they are asking. What is S2 they are asking? A2 they are asking. Find the third term. A3 they are asking. And 10th term, A10 is what they are asking.
And An equal to what we have to calculate. To calculate all these, we have to make use of Sn formula given to us.
S1 equal to A. You can call A as A1 also, no problem. S1 equal to four into one minus one square. In place of n here, you put one, you will get S1. That is four into one minus one square. And right here, n equal to one. They only have given what is the sum of n terms. So you will have here 4 minus 1, that is equal to 3. S1 equal to 3 means what? A is equal to 3. How do you calculate A2 then? A2 is equal to S2 minus A, because A plus A2 is S2. Is it right? And right here, since S2 is equal to A plus A2, sum of two terms means A plus A2. From this you can get A2 as S2 minus A. Now how do you calculate S2? Sn formula is given to us. That is 4 into 2 minus 2 square. 4n minus n square it is. So you get here 8 minus 4, that is equal to 4 minus 3. Here also minus 3 minus 3. So A2 becomes what? 1. A2 becomes equal to 1. What is S2? From above calculation, S2 is equal to, here this is S2. Here 8 minus 4, 4. Yes, 1 plus 3, that is also 4, equal to 4. S2 formula only they have given, no? So you can calculate that as 4n minus n square. Okay, right. Now to find third term. Can you calculate D here now? Now D equal to A2 minus A. Minus 2. Minus 2. Correct. Therefore, A3 equal to what? A3 equal to A2 plus D. A2 is 1, 1 minus 2, it will become minus 1 minus 1. What is 10th term? A10 equal to A plus 9D using what? Yes, using An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. So 3 plus 3 plus 9 into minus 2, 3 minus 18, get minus 15. You get minus 15. So can you now write AN? Nth term. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Whatever we have calculated, you put that value. A is 3 plus N minus 1 into minus 2. That is 3 plus minus 2N plus 2, n into minus 2 minus 2n, minus 1 into minus 2 plus 2. It will become 5 minus 2n. You can verify by taking n equal to 10. 5 minus 20 will get. 5 minus 20 is minus 15. A10 you have calculated, that is also minus 15. That means this expression for an is correct.